Let me be your hero. Would you dance if I asked you to dance? Would you run and never look back? Would you cry if you saw me crying? And would you save my soul tonight? Would you tremble if I touched your lips? Or would you laugh? Oh, please tell me this. Now would you die for the one you love? Oh, hold me in your arms tonight. I can be your hero, baby. I can kiss away the pain. I will stand by you forever. You can take my breath away. Would you swear that you'll always be mine? Or would you lie? Would you run and hide? Am I in too deep? Have I lost my mind? I don't care, you're here tonight. I can be your hero, baby. Kiss away the pain. I will stand by you forever. You can take my breath away.
But it's been 15,904 days that we've been married, and I wouldn't change anything. I have zero regrets, period, about anything. We got married young, and I'll tell you more at the celebration, but we just fit. But we were both born at the exact same time, which I think was 6:20 in the morning, And Jan always thought that was pretty amazing. So we've always felt like soulmates. And, you know, 43 years, it's just disappeared. It's gone in an instant. And I'm going to share something with you. I've gone through thousands of photos, because I took photos our entire marriage with Jan and the girls screaming like, no, don't take photos. And if I can get the video equipment to work correctly, you'll see some little cameos where Jan's doing this and stop and whatever. And it was like that probably for the first 20 years, but I got a lot of good stuff. And for you folks that are young, if you're not taking photos, or somebody isn't the designated photographer or videographer, I'm encouraging you to do so, because the memories fade. If I didn't have the photos, and I've got a good memory, if I don't have the photos, there's not a lot to fall back on. I just want to tell you how much it means to me that you made an effort to hike up here, travel, come, and join us for celebrating Jan and remembering her. Yeah, so the reason I chose this spot, we were up here and you can see the lake, and then actually I was going to do it up above, and Brent, my brother, was with me and Kaylee and Melissa, and he came over and said, Garth, this is the spot right here in these granite boulders, and it was perfect. But we hunted over there, snowshoed over there, and mountain biked over there. We hiked all through here, all year round. So a lot of the stuff I have for my videos are us enjoying the four seasons up here, because you have to. I mean, if you really are going to live here, it just forces you to, right, Tracy? Yeah, I mean, it just, when we first moved on the lake, we were very surprised that nobody was out on the ice. We thought, what the heck? So I started making ice skating rinks with the four-wheeler, and we have a lot of good memories and a lot of good footage of that. But I thought this was appropriate because she's got some shade, she's got a clear view. No one's going to mess with it. I'm not going to be up to her logging, because there's nothing that can't cut down. And the guys that ride the four-wheeler stay up on the ridge up there pretty much. So that's why we chose it. And it's, you know, my mom, she's 87. She says, why would you do it up there? You won't be able to visit her. And then a week later she says, I know why you put it up there. You'll be able to visit her, because I'll tell you a funny story, and then we'll do the rest of the things. We can get back and everybody can get cleaned up if they want. We'd talk, and I always told her I want to live to be 120. And I said, what about you? She says, oh, no, not that long. I said, you don't want to be with me till I'm 120? She says, no. I said, well, how long do you want to live? She says, 80, 85. I said, well, why? She says, because I just do. And I said, well, I'm going to live to be 120. Are you sure you don't want to join me? And she says, oh, God, no. She says, I don't want to be there changing your diaper. And I said, well, I don't want to be there if I'm having a diaper either. But if you're gone at 85 and I hit 120, guess what I'm going to do? She says, what? I said, I'm going to get myself a brand new 60-year-old girlfriend, and she's going to be a babe. And she said, well, you have fun with that. Anyway, that was our, that's what happened. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put the urn inside the crate over there, and then just one by one, you drop your flower on it, your daffodil?
They're gladiolas.
Gladiolas.
This was our grandparents grew this at their house, my grandfather, our whole entire lives. He had so many that they'd mixed together. So it kind of became a family thing, like the gladiolus, and it's important. I got one on my arm, I carried it at my wedding, and now we're going to come over there.
A thousand lives have made me colder, and I don't think I can look at this the same. Disappear now when I'm dreaming of your face.